Excuse me, I'd like to open up an account.
Well, great. What type of account do you have in mind?
This kind.
The Old Man and the Gun is based on an article in The New Yorker about Forrest Tucker, who spent his entire life robbing banks, getting arrested, breaking out of prison, on and on for his whole life.
You said he was armed.
He had a gun.
You saw it.
Well, he was also sort of a gentleman.
The idea of being free from the law, being free from strict rule, I was always attracted to that sensibility. And this film offered that chance, but in an upbeat way that would be fun.
Forrest, he's a criminal, but he's just so damn charming.
Don't go breaking my heart now, okay?
Look at that. Is he smiling?
It's big.
Real big. Do you think we can pull it off?
Because this movie's so much about Bob's legacy and honoring that, it just felt like an opportunity to create movie history.
A lot of the films I've made involve characters who were outlaws. They wanted to escape the boundaries of how you're supposed to live a life. So I think that was sort of in my DNA.
It's the idea of the renegade, the idea of people who cannot adjust to the restrictions in society.
You know what I do when the door closes?
What's that?
I jump out the window.
Redford is somebody I've watched my whole life. He has an enormous amount of presence, and I think that he brings something special to every part that he plays, and it's partly who he is, and it's partly the character he's playing, and it's fun to watch.
You were involved with that Over the Hill gang, right?
Yeah.
Did you catch him?
Not yet.
I think I saw this as my time to leave the stage. I've been acting since I was 21, and when you get to be 80, that's enough. This feels like a good project maybe to go out on.